Hey y'all, good afternoon and welcome to a hot day here on the homestead. So today I'm working on this little mobility scooter for a friend of mine. His mother lives exactly a quarter of a mile behind his house and they have a very nice paved walkway that she can walk back and forth. She does not like driving the golf cart because it's a big step up into the golf cart. So she found this little mobility scooter. She used it for a week, was super happy with it until it didn't run anymore. Brought it over to me and I've already fixed it. It was just a jumper wire. Somebody's done some very crazy wiring on this thing. So I'm going to repair that wiring. I'll bring you guys along for that, but it's a basic stuff. The key that was used for this thing was a screwdriver. So I've replaced that. I am replacing that with a push button. And then the other thing I'm going to be doing is I got a new charger for it because the charger it came with was junk. I got a 3 amp charger for this. It's 48 volts. We're not messing with the lead acid batteries. We actually want the weight in this thing. This thing actually does wheelies as it is, so I'm not going to change the batteries out. The batteries are fine. They just need a good charger. So the charger is going to be built in so that all she has to do is pull up to her porch and plug the extension cord in when she needs to charge it. Okay y'all, so here is the key switch that I'm going to be installing, or the push button latching deal. I wish I could actually solder that connector on first, but it won't because then I can't get it through the hole. So I'll drill this through and then solder on the connectors there. And that button's going to go right there. Alright, so that was a pain in the butt trying to hold this and not being able to see, but I got it soldered on. So now I'm just going to slide this back through, tighten that bolt real quick. And just like that, we got a power button that works. Now I can plug that back in. And yay! There we go. That was easy enough. All right, I'm gonna put the front cover back on and call that good. Just like that, it's back together. All right guys, so here's the charger. And the charger, I'm gonna mount it right to the bottom of this metal plate on the seat. It'll do a couple things. It'll keep it up and out of the weather, but it'll also keep it against this metal, which will help hopefully reduce the little bit of heat that this thing does put off. I'm going to use Velcro to Velcro it on, but also I'm going to drill a couple of holes and then run some zip ties through those holes so that I can secure it that way. So that means I've got to take the seat off. So that's the next step. Nice. So I got four pieces on there. I'm just gonna flip this bad boy around. Place it right there. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and drill some holes so I can wrap these zip ties around. And to keep it from going side to side, I'm going to put one here and there. Okay, so the power cord, all I'm going to do is I'm going to have it just push through this hole up here in the front. So that they can just have this. This will just be hanging out in the front and then you can just plug the extension cord into that. All right, now that I got that through there, I'm just gonna go ahead and plug this in. And then I'm just gonna wrap these wires up. Nice and just like that. That's all I'm gonna do. And I'm gonna put a zip tie on there. So the part that actually plugs in to charge up the batteries, I'm gonna do the same with it. Have it about that long.
zip side this down. And now they have an onboard charger at all times.
All right, y'all, so obviously I gotta put the seat back on, but before I do that, I'm gonna go ahead and, as you can see, all these crazy wires down here. These jumper wires are not acceptable. Obviously these butt connectors don't work well, and I can't let that slide. So what I'm gonna do is I've got some 10 gauge silicone wire. I am gonna pull all those connectors out, and I'm gonna put new 10 gauge silicone wire in there. Guys, I'm sorry, I'm not gonna be able to film this. It's just too tight of an area to try to film.
All right, y'all, I've switched everything out. As you can see now, it's silicone 10 gauge wire. I left this one here because it's 10 gauge and the connector was a pain in the butt. I removed that stupid breaker, which was not proper. I put an inline fuse, which is proper. And this one right here, unfortunately, it's going to have to stay. It is for the charger, however, so it's not that big of a deal. It's not drawing 40 amps through, you know, that, or whatever this thing is rated for. But yeah, much, much better. So next, we're going to go ahead and get that seat on.
Hey, kid, don't ever let them get inside your head. They'll tell you what to do in life instead of everything you know that you could get. Don't let them guide your life towards regret. I'll fight for what I love with every breath. My past is filled with things I want.
Seats back on. Locks in place. Hell yeah.
All right, here we go.
I use them all to push me to my best. So treat the worst of times just like a test. If only I could go back in time, I'd tell myself that everything will end up alright. Just push yourself, test yourself, figure out what you like. Find your limits, don't be rigid, always work towards a prime. Surround yourself with open minds, people can change your life. A few friends with intent can help you feel alive. Find a passion, take some action, and with a little time, just be patient, make a statement, try to enjoy your life. They'll try to kick you while you're down.
They want to rise up while you drown. 15 kilometers an hour.
They want to fill your head with doubt. They're silently scared that you'll figure it out. I'll make it look like I'm losing. Won't bother hiding.
So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, you know what to do. Please leave them below. Thanks a lot. Take care. And God bless.